Steel, the backbone of industry. It's everywhere. Hairpins, helicopters, high-rises, you name it. But steel's production consumes a lot of energy and thus money, more and more money. Since 2022, energy prices in Europe have risen by up to 40%.
The bigger challenge of the steel industry in Europe is the cost to remain competitive. Well, we have a challenge with the price of energy, of course. We are huge consumers.
Moreover, the European steel industry accounts for about 5% of the EU's total CO2 emissions. Innovation is overdue.
We need steel for everything we do. And we can make steel manufacturing sustainable. We can make it low emissions by ensuring that any bit of energy is used in a very efficient way and no energy is being wasted. No water is being wasted. This is our hope, and by achieving this, we'll have a very sustainable steel manufacturing process.
Husam Juhara is the technical lead of the EU project iWAYS, in which he devised the Radiative Heat Pipe Condensing Economiser, HPCE for short. His innovative heat exchange technology is now being integrated into the furnace line at the Spanish steel mill, Tubacex.
This system recovers the heat from the hot steel that goes through the ovens. It also condenses the vapor that is evaporated when we cool those surfaces. And when it condenses it, it absorbs that heat also, and it cools the air that is departing those ovens. The heat that is absorbed is then recycled back to the plant and is used in the degreasing tanks that they have in the factory. So we are basically absorbing heat that was otherwise wasted, putting the heat back in the process, saving fuel that was used to do that heating.
But installing the new system in a 24-hour live industrial environment was no small feat.
The main challenge was to install it without disturbing production. It's very difficult to install HPCE on top of the furnace without hindering production and maintenance teams to access the machine.
The first test run of the HPCE was successful, proving it to be a promising technology.
With the help of the HPCE, we will be able to reduce gas consumption and CO2 emissions.
Alongside recovering waste heat, the iWAYS partners also targeted industrial water. The steel industry uses large volumes of water to clean and cool equipment.
The water here is quite dirty. I mean, they use it in order to degrease the stainless steel products. So it contains many organic compounds, and there is a need to treat it in order to reuse it. So filtration is one of the best approaches in our days.
To permit the polluted water to be reused, the experts installed a pre-treatment stage, which removes about 80% of the particles. Two steps of filtration follow. The first is membrane distillation.
It is actually a hydrophobic membrane that allows only water vapor to pass through. So at this stage, the effect is very high, and we can remove about 99% of the contaminants, either organic or inorganic.
Some volatile contaminants can still pass through. Therefore, the final stage of the process is nanofiltration. Here, high surface area materials, coated with a special catalyst, break down the remaining contaminants under UV radiation.
The benefits are that you can recover about 95% of the water to be reused in the industry.
The results so far are significant, both for the environment and for the factory.
I'm hoping iWAYS will pave the way to stop all of that waste, collect it, bring it back to the process, recycling the water, recycling the heat, achieve over 90% of recycling all of those quantities back to the process.
Reducing waste and emissions could be key to keeping steel production in Europe and elsewhere viable and sustainable.